right, let's work a rational equation. All right, with what I mean by rational, I'm saying here the rational exponent. So again, like I was saying in the lecture, these also can be a little bit tricky. So what do we want to do first? All right, well, to get started, I need this x to the 2/3 by itself. All right, so that means I need to add 8 to both sides. All right, and that's going to be my first step here. So I add 8 to both sides, so negative 4 plus 8, it gives me positive 4. All right, and now I want to try to undo this fractional exponent, okay? And how am I going to do that? I'm going to use the reciprocal power. All right, and so you can see how I'm using the power 3/2. All right, now why would I do that? Again, it's a reciprocal, meaning, and let me grab a slightly different color here so you can see what I mean by that. If I were to multiply these two fractions, I'm getting 1. All right, so that's why we use the 3/2 to undo the 2/3. All right, so where does that leave me? That leaves me with x to the 1, and we know that, so I can write a 1 there, but I don't need to. All right, and 4 to the 3/2. Now, remember what I said in lecture. When the numerator is even, and 2 is clearly even, then what we're getting is a plus minus on the right side. All right, it's very similar to taking when we square root both sides. Okay, and the square root comes from that the 2 now being in the denominator. All right, so we need to actually simplify 4 to the 3/2. All right, we can type it in our calculator, and if you want to type it in your calculator, you'll do 4 caret in parentheses 3 divided by 2. Okay, or we can just think of this as the square root of 4 all cubed. All right, because the 3 is the power and the 2 is the root. All right, and just keep in mind with square roots, we don't write the 2. All right, and so I can simplify this. All right, and so the square root of 4 is in fact 2. And now I just need to cube 2, so 2 times 2 times 2, I'm getting plus or minus 8 as my answer.